r/AskReddit. What is something that once you noticed it, you can now no longer unnotice it? Empty cups. I don't know why most shows and movies can't be bothered to put a liquid of any sort into coffee cups for scenes. You can tell when someone is holding a cup with something in it or just acting like it, and fake sips never come out well. Sometimes you can literally see the emptiness. I was an extra on a TV show once and was given a to-go coffee cup to hold. Then the prop guy came around and filled all the cups with water, just so they would have weight. I thanked him for his service, cause it always bugged the ever-loving shit out of me. Actors glancing down for their mark. Once you're aware, you look for it in every scene. It's most easily spotted in sitcoms. This reminds me of season 1 Fresh Prince. Apparently Will had a habit of mouthing other people's lines in scenes and I can't unsee it now. He does it in the episode with Don Cheadle. Ice Tray is the character's name, lol. I think I heard that Emma Watson does this in Harry Potter ATPs. How humans naturally break eye contact when talking to each other. Every 3 seconds, they glance away. Now every time I talk to someone, I notice them glancing away. Supposedly it's a way to communicate in a non-threatening manner, as staring equals intent, either sexual or violent. Oh good, I thought I was weird for not keeping constant eye contact. That's all I think about while having a convo, then I miss what they say entirely. IDK, but you ever get a car and then notice you start seeing that car everywhere? This is caused by the simulation not having enough memory to store all the different vehicles. So you end up with some duplication and start seeing banshees everywhere once you get one. When you're a welder, you notice how shitty most welds are that hold crucial components together. Ex-weld inspector here. You're so right and it scares the shit out of me. I'm not even a real welder, but once I started learning to weld as a hobby, I noticed how often welds out in the world look like little poo-poos. Mickey Mouse's ears are, by design, always facing the camera. If you watch almost any Disney show with Mickey in it, his ears will migrate around the silhouette of his head. In certain instances, his ears will even switch sides. Tom Cruise's front tooth. That dude's entire face was like, what if we have really good symmetry, but not the way you're thinking. His teeth used to be crazy wonky and now still not right, which is fine. I just think for all the money he spent to get his teeth fixed, he would not have wound up with what he has. How many times someone says "um" or other filler words? Filler words are considered a normal part of speech, 2% of spoken words or so, which is actually kind of a lot. It made me more forgiving of when I use them myself, which in turn ended up meaning I use fewer of them. But yes, once I notice in a given conversation, there's no going back. Every time you swallow, your ears click. God damn it. Just swallowed 3 times in a row to make sure. Sure hope I forget this. You won't. Didn't you read the title? Vet Tech here. I recently realized that one of Grey's Anatomy's background noises is the noise a fluid pump makes when it needs to be reset. It is a noise I am very familiar with and one that grates on my nerves. Daniel Radcliffe's awkward acting jaw. He juts it out a bit, giving himself an underbite look. And his out of sync blinks. Yes, he blinks one eye at a time. He seems to have it under control now. But if you watch early Harry Potter, it's unnerving. Singers breathing in music. So many breaths. Bad green screen in movies. Totally breaks immersion. Driving scenes are the worst for this, especially in older movies shows. Doesn't help that the driver spends the scene slightly wiggling the steering wheel while spending maybe 1 cumulative second actually looking at the road. Stripper poles are rigged to rotate on bearings. When a stripper elegantly runs up to a pole and spins around it, the pole is rotating. If it didn't, strippers would get the worst chafing. No worries. Sliding down still chafes, especially if you're just starting out. Also, not all poles rotate. In competitive pole sports, the stage will have 2 poles. One static, one spinning. How Chris Pratt always sounds like Chris Pratt. My mind can't undo it. In Glee, the show choir was named New Directions BC. The PPL in charge thought it was funny that it sounded like New Directions. A sign maker for a local Chinese restaurant made an error when creating the lighted sign for the business. It reads, we delivery. Instead of free delivery, they let the Chinese restaurant have the sign for free if they accepted it as is. I'd never noticed the we delivery until it was pointed out. I always thought it was an error on we deliver. The word bed looks like a side view of a bed. The word boob shows you top view, front view, side view. Damn, after a month of quarantine it looked kinda fine. Whoopi Goldberg doesn't have eyebrows. As a kid I loved her movies. Never once did I realize she has no eyebrows. When I got older I realized it and pointed it out to my mom, who also never realized. We can't look at her the same. Fun fact. Whoopi Goldberg has been 55 years old her entire life. In movies and TV, nobody ever says bye at the end of a phone call. The variety of shapes of people's ears. Fun fact. Each person's ears are unique, so you could actually take an earprint like a fingerprint to identify people. I only started noticing this the more piercings I got. Some people have such weird shaped ears. I'm sorry in advance. McCulloch effect. The phenomenon was discovered by Celeste McCulloch in 1965. McCulloch found that staring at colorful gratings for too long can affect vision for months to come. Turns out, looking at these gratings for more than 10 minutes can have the effect last over 3 months. I tried it and it lasted about a week or two whenever I looked at anything resembling bars such as a fence. Mona Lisa looks like George Washington. That's WHOITs. I always knew she looked familiar and figured meh. She's in so many cartoons and other cinematic things. I'm just familiar with her face. George. Ducking. Washington. Thank you. Thank you so much. This mystery has been lurking in the bottom of my brain for over 2 decades. Sometimes I can see my heartbeat inside one of my eyes. It's like my vision slightly darkens in a specific spot for just a moment. It's easier to see when outdoors. Look up blue field entoptic phenomenon. It's a known visual phenomenon, mostly visible when in bright light and especially against blue backgrounds, like a bright summer sky, and really is your blood vessels pumping blood through your retina. Source: I'm optician and had to study crazy things like this. Every time I need to trim my fingernails, totally fine one sec, then I'm going crazy, they're so long, everything is awful. A light to mild case of tinnitus. The kind that you forget about until jerks like me remind you. Like losing the game. I've had this for years without realizing it. The weird thing is I never saw it as a bad thing until I learned what tinnitus is. For a good while after that I always noticed the ringing and it was annoying. But once I ignored it again things went back to normal. So now I don't look at it as a bad thing. I see it as the sound my brain makes when it's awake. Kind of like that high-pitched sound older TVs used to make when you turn them on. It makes dealing with it a whole lot easier. Laugh tracks. After watching some streaming shows without them I can't stand them. People's verbal tics. Once I notice someone uses a word or sound without noticing, like um or uhh, I have trouble focusing on anything else. For example, I have a coworker that uses alright as a filler word and I don't think he realizes how often he says it. Alright, we ran the test and, alright, once we pulled up the data, alright, we found that such and such didn't read like we expected, alright, so we pulled up the first time we ran this test, alright, and what we saw that time, alright, was, I've gotten to the point that I just count his alrights instead of actually listening to him. My students do this. I started clicking my pen every time they said Surprisingly, even without knowing why I was doing the pen click, they stopped pretty quickly. Plus, it's better than counting. How 99% of movie posters are blue and orange. Now that's thinking with portals. Hugh Laurie's American accent on House MD. If I had to describe it, it's like him doing an American accent without an actual American accent. Everywhere in the US, people have accents. Even the people who don't think they have one, have one. They just don't hear it because they've been around it their entire lives. So his delivery is just a flat intonation of what a non-American would probably think we all sound like. And it works. He's a great actor. It's just once I noticed it in the show I couldn't forget it. It's like the non-regional accents that TV news anchors have. I'm a nurse. I can't help but look at people's veins to assess where I'd place the IV. Those two-pronged coat hangers that look like drunk octopuses. Any random faces in any pattern. There's one in my bathroom's linoleum floor that watches me on the throne ever since I saw it. The eye vibration. Whenever actors want to seem super emotional and intense, they kind of vibrate their eyes back and forth really quickly. No one knows what I'm talking about, but I swear it's true. When you type LOL, it looks like a little stick figure dude drowning. When I went to university when I was younger, I had to take a design class. I was in university for web development, so this seemed related. I was immediately turned off from the class because it had nothing directly related to web design but was just a class on design principles. I grew to cherish the lessons I had learned, and it made me realize how poorly designed most consumer shit truly is. Sit in a vehicle but it's hard to see out the back window? Shit design. Buy a blender and want to clean it only to find it awful and difficult? Shit design. Want to log into your government's website and change your settings but it only works in IE8? Shit design. You get the point. Any time in life you notice something or some product acting as a hindrance to you is shit design. Remove these products from your life as soon as possible and do your best to not reward these companies with your money. Chicago Bulls logo upside down looks like a robot is violating a crab. I always thought it looked like a robot reading a book. Now you've ruined me. Thanks. When you watch a film at the cinema, even though most are digital transmissions, they still have the odd white fleck you sometimes notice. This is the watermark that uniquely identifies that film being played. So if it is pirated and put on the web, then the film companies know exactly which cinema it was played in. Giada De Laurentiis on the Food Network has a big head. And approximately 3,000 teeth. I'm obese, and I feel my weight. It's a good thing. I feel absurdly heavy. My back hurts. Moving my torso takes a ton of work. My stomach is problematic, and my center of gravity is way too high. Once I felt it, I felt motivated to lose that feeling. Ever notice how all stars seem to have the same spiky shape regardless of their size? I notice it whenever I look up at the night sky now. The shape you see is completely unique to your eye's own geography, how the small lines on them smear the light. So they will all look slightly different to each person. That's also why when you are looking at telescopic pictures of stars, you can sometimes tell what kind of aperture they used to take the pictures. For example, Hubble telescope pictures usually have fairly distinctive four-point stars. How often people interrupt each other during a conversation? That scratch in the middle of your glasses. Or when you suddenly notice there's dust all over the lenses and your vision immediately gets worse until you wipe them off. My wife pointed out that sometimes makeup artists will draw lipstick outside the lips to make the lips bigger, different shapes, etc. I freaking see it everywhere now. Sleep apps with white noise have a repeat on them. I can't use them because my mind latches onto the repeat and keeps me up. A bunch of Led Zeppelin songs. Like Since I've Been Loving You, Houses of the Holy, and All My Love have a squeaky bass drum pedal. Apparently, the bass pedal John Bonham used was called the Ludwig Speed King, and there was no way to oil the inner mechanisms. Characters in movies will never explain the plan if it's going to succeed, they'll just show it happen. Breaking Bad's camera just shaking the whole time. Whoa. You made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.